In a second paper, we looked at the wider pattern of human occupation and dispersal in North America, applying a powerful tool called Bayesian statistical modeling using the OxCal software developed here in Oxford. We analyzed hundreds of dates from 42 archaeological sites in North America and Beringia, with Beringia being the land bridge connecting North America and Asia. The results show that although humans were present in North America before the last glacial maximum, it wasn't until much later, during a period of abrupt global climate warming that occurred roughly between 15,000 and 13,000 years ago, that we see an increase in human occupation. We also find that the start dates for the three major stone tools in these regions, Western Stemmed, Clovis, and Beringian, are statistically indistinguishable around this date. At the same time, we see an increase in human population shown by the wider distribution of archaeological sites across these regions, as well as Y chromosome, mitochondrial, and nuclear ancient DNA evidence. A range of now extinct animals, including camels, horses, and mammoths, disappear at this time too. We suggest, therefore, that there's a strong link between the human population rise and the catastrophic decline of large megafauna occurring at the same time, although we can't exclude the role of climate change. A combination of new archaeological excavations and cutting-edge archaeological science is allowing us to uncover a new story to the colonization of the American continent. The first Americans came from Eastern Eurasia, but it looks as though there was a surprisingly early movement of humans into the continent as early as 30,000 years ago. This new research is raising a number of new questions regarding who these humans were, how they lived, how widespread they were, and ultimately what their fate and legacy was.